Ladies and gentlemen, Frank Warren for Queensbury Promotions and MGM Promotions, sponsored by Raynham Steel, proudly presents the main event of the evening. 10 3-minute rounds for the vacant WBO Intercontinental Super Flyweight Championship, live and exclusive on Box Nation from the National Stadium here in Dublin. Your officials are appointed by the WBO, and your three scoring judges at ringside are Mr. Dave Paris of England, Jose Martinez of Spain, Agostino De Giovanni of Italy. Your WBO representative is Mr. John Handler of England. Your Boxing Union of Ireland representative is Mr. Mel Crystal. And your timekeeper at the bell is Alex McKenzie. And when the action begins, your referee in charge is Mickey Van of Leeds, England. And now to introduce the contestants. Firstly, fighting out of the red corner, stands a man with a record of 13 wins, 2 losses, 1 draw, with 8 KOs to his name. At yesterday's weigh-in, he scaled 8 stone, 1 pound, 7 ounces. And tonight, he wears the green, silver, and red shorts. Please welcome from Yucatan, Mexico, Julia Granados. And across the ring, in the blue corner, stands a man whose unbeaten record reads 13 wins with 8 KOs to his name. At yesterday's weigh-in, he scaled 8 stone, 2 pounds at 7 ounces. And tonight, he wears the black and gold shorts. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome from Belfast, he's the Irish Mexican. He is Jamie Conley! Ladies and gentlemen, it's time to go toe-to-toe. Your referee will now give his final instructions to both boxers.
Both have the instructions in the dressing room, obey my command at all times. No noise with the head. Check hands.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is the vacant WBO Intercontinental Super Flyweight Championship.
Final words of advice from Danny Bourne, Jamie Conlon's trainer. Only a pound between them at the weigh-in. I would mind betting that there's a little bit more than a single pound between them now. Conlon, very much the bigger man in Granados, as you've heard earlier. Campaigned predominantly as a flyweight. And is he going to be able to make the transition into this higher weight division? Good boxer, though. Come forward type. And he's aggressive, Barry. Good left hook.
Yeah, he's aggressive. He's got a good left hook. He's got a good work rate as well. But Conlon is massive for the weight. And I think he's just, without being a devastating puncher, he's a strong puncher.
Conlon said that he certainly sees that he could fight it. Bantamweight if necessary.
Well, he's big enough. For 5'7", that's massive for the weight. But as Joe Calzaghe said, if you're not struggling to make the weight, you're in the wrong weight. So as long as you can make the limit, he's better off staying where he is.
Babyface, isn't he, the Mexican? 6 years the younger man. Good jab.
Yeah, it's good. When you're facing a come-forward fighter, the jab, and a solid jab as well, is a very important weapon just to stop them in their tracks. Gives you a chance to move as well.
Was formerly trained by John Breen, the wise Belfast trainer. Sure that John will be watching here. They left on pretty decent terms, I think. Worked with Eamon McGee as well. But he says that he's gelled with Danny Bourne and he's enjoying working with him in the Marbella training base. He's got those high cheekbones, Jamie Conlon, and he tends to mark up. Already, just a little bit of reddening, just a nice jab from Conlon. guard though from Granados.
To be honest, Granados is coming, he's trying to think, be clever, he's thinking about his work, he's trying to be a little bit clever coming forward, not just marching forward, but being a punch bag for Conlon. So, you know, he's coming with a little bit of ambition, which is good to see. But at this stage of Conlon's career now, he needs good tests.
Old now, Jamie Conlon. Talked about John Breen, it was Breen who called him the Mexican, you know. Well, interesting opening round. And you can see reddening around that right eye of Jamie Conlon already.
I thought that was a decent little round there for Conlon. You know, it was Granados who was on the front foot, and trying to push Conlon back.
Well,
Conlon boxed quite well.
Let's have a look at him now, yeah.
Under a little bit of pressure.
Okay, I want you now, that little half a step back. I want you to bring it up the middle now with the right hand. Okay? Straight, 1, 2, half a step back. The uppercut's on now, so just nice and relaxed. Yeah? Great. Jab, half a step back, uppercut. And look for the left hook on it. So jab, bring him in, uppercut left hook. And the straight right hand, other than that, just behind that jab all the time.
Alright,
give yourself room, that was nice, yeah. A little bit faster with the jab. But just put him under pressure with upper body movement too, yeah? So the right hand I'm looking for, up the middle, left hook, and the straight right hand. Okay? But look.
So we move into the second round. Barry's given Jamie Conlon that opener. But not by a wide margin.
Good there from Greenwood, doubling up with the left hook there. Again, good shot.
It's a solid shot.
That's also good for Granados. He's giving away a lot of natural height advantage. But sometimes you're better to go even lower. Make yourself an even smaller target. Make the bigger guy punch down with less accuracy.
Landed with a couple of shots to the head there. Uppercut followed by the left hook. Left hook was blocked, but looks as though he's got a bit of power in his punches as well.
And it's also intelligent pressure fighting here from Granados. With slipping punches coming forward. And Conlon and Allen having too much success there. Time right hand from him there.
Right hand over the top.
But when you fight a guy who moves his head a lot, you've got to throw that jab to the chest.
I'm sure he'd have had a few nerves tonight, you know, Jamie Conlon, when he made his way in, because good as he is, and proud fighter though he is, this is the first time that he's topped a bill. And with that comes just a little bit of added pressure, maybe. Desire to really produce you very fast.
Yeah, of course, you know, and there's already talk of bigger fights ahead waiting for him, you know, with quality opposition, and Paul Butler being the main one, so, you know, he's out to impress and out to show that he belongs at that level.
Nicky Van, the Leeds referee, nice work again, yeah. From Granados, good left hand.
But it was a jab, he missed with a jab, and he came up with an uppercut, didn't he? A little screw shot, handling well. Conlon just mixing up the jab there, he's got to go change the angle of the jab.
It's nicely schooled though, Granados.
Well, Conlon's just got his boxing together a little bit in the last 30 seconds or so, but I think it's been so far a good round here for Granados. Again, it's a good head movement.
Conlon being forced to give ground. Granados just likes to get on the front foot, doesn't he? Likes to be the aggressor, I suppose you might say. Might sound a bit of a cliche, but kind of typically Mexican.
Yeah, and also that slipping punches and throwing. But they like to slip a punch and they throw while your punch is still over their shoulder. But they certainly roll on fighters, aren't they? Short right hand there and taking them back there from Conlon.
Close round.
That's a Granados round, I think. Jamie got his boxing together in the last 30, 40 seconds, but I think Ben Rados educated the pressure fighting from him.
Well, let's see you start bringing a little, just leaving that in now, yeah. Speed. Let's see you start bringing the left hook into play now. The long right hook round the sides is on as well. But I want you to throw it up the middle, it's on. Just jab, half a step back and let it go. You've got to keep your own, he's got a little good right hand, this kid. You've got to keep your left hand tight all the time. So when you're jabbing, left hand back to your chin. But everything you do behind the jab, stop jumping around now, wasting energy. Let's see you walk. As he comes bang, lead him with it. One, two, up the middle, go for it. Now let's see you bring the left hook into play now. The third one, start finishing with the left hook. Bang, bang, bang. Touch the first two, start banging them in, yeah?
As ever, really clear, precise instructions from Danny Bourne. Moving now into the third round. Ten rounds of this. Rados again onto the front foot, starting aggressively. Baris Card did enough to take that second round, squares it up.
Good there for Colin, a sharp right hand.
A look at the fight which could turn into a bit of a war, this one, Barry.
Yeah, I think at some stage, I think Colin's going to have to try and push him back. I think Gretzler looks like a momentum fighter. Once he gets a little bit of momentum in his work, he brings full of confidence, as he's shown in that second round, and again here early in the third.
Has to adopt plan B. Will he have it? It's the, I guess, the problem with Paul Butler. Tete, the South African, really did produce one of the outstanding performances from a visitor to British shores in recent years. But Rados has already done enough here to show that he is certainly no fool. Body shots right on the border, yeah, it was low.
It was right on the border. I'll tell you what, he looks very relaxed, doesn't he, Rados? Really relaxed.
He's got a very easy style, hasn't he? He's not much stressed at all by it, just rolls his way in and delivers good body shots. As you said earlier, educated pressure.
Even though Conlon himself's having a bit of success, you know.
A very good fight, this.
At the moment, you've got to be edging maybe Granados. That's good there for Conlon. You've got to make it, every time he misses, you've got to make him pay for his mistakes.
Blood now coming from the nose of Conlon. It's good though.
Lovely uppercut though from Granados, but then nice shout, Conlon's back from Conlon. It's a good little fight, this.
It is, but as you say, Granados has that rhythm and he has a menacing look about him. He certainly believes.
Just a little bit short there with the right hand, Granados.
Granados complaining that there was a clash of heads there. Referee said nothing. And just momentarily, it's just taking a bit of impetus out of his work.
Yeah.
That's good.
Yeah, that's good, that's good, that's good. That's good.
Conlon having a good 30 or 40 seconds at the back end of this round. Spirit between them, touch of gloves as they make their way back to the corner.
I want you to start dropping their body shots in though, yeah? I want to start seeing you touching the top, left hook to the body. You hurt him with one, then it looks like you hurt him. Feeling all right, yeah? Behind the jab. I want to see a little bit more neat and tidy in what you're at. You've got to get that left hand back to your chin. I want to see your one, two left into the body. Jab right through down the side. Back on the jab and bring one up the middle every now and then. It's quite open, you know what? You haven't threw it once. Start bringing it up the middle. Pack your feet. Show your feet down, up the middle left hook. One, two left hook to the body. The long right hook now is on. He's bending onto it. But everything you do behind the jab, just nice and relaxed. Yeah? Well,
good fight on Barry's scorecard. He's given that one to Granados.
Yeah, not by
was
much.
That low punch?
Yeah, it was a little bit low, wasn't it? Not by much, man. I think Conlon come back into the round. Second half, but I just confirmed Granados' educated pressure.
Good fight. Moving into the fourth. Nicky Van did say beforehand, no noughties with the head. One of his trademark sayings. Still graceful at, what is he now, 67, 68, Mickey? He's in good nick, isn't he?
Nice to see him in the ring, isn't it?
Ballroom dancer, and you see the way he moves around the ring, Mickey Van, you can certainly see it. Nice left hand from Conlon.
He's going to have to work hard tonight, Conlon. You can see that already, can't you? He's going to have to throw a lot of punches.
He doesn't look easily moved, does he, this Mexican lad?
Yeah, good success here from Conor with the right hand. I think he's got to try and push him back. I think Conor has a solid jab. I think he needs to double it up and try and push him back.
Jab's going to be his key, isn't he, with that reach advantage.
And every now and again, just change direction, just move to the... Not all the time, just move to the right.
Fitness is sure to be tested. That's a lovely body shot from Conor. And again. Intriguing. And the fans' reaction kind of reflecting that. It's not quite as passionate as it might be at the moment. Still at the formative stage of the fight. Nobody quite sure who's going to emerge victorious at this point.
That's good from Conlon there, just following through those punches.
Jabbing well in this fall.
Still going to be forceful with that jab. That's good. Again, following through.
He was clipped by a left hand though as he came in.
But even though he got hit, he carried on with the combination, and that's what gave him a little bit of success.
Sees it. He's going looking for Conlon here, who needs to hold on and ride this one out. These are anxious times, and still 15 seconds to go in this round. Conlon now is having to really dig deep and fight his way back here. Great right hand that was from Granados, and much of Conlon's good work before that was negated by that one power shot, and that shows the danger of this Mexican, but a great left hand as well from Conlon. Terrific uppercut. What an exchange, and a dramatic last 20 seconds to the round.
Unbelievable. It seemed that Conlon was having a decent little run. He wasn't winning by a mile, but he's boxing well. But that big right hand there from Granados totally changed the whole dynamics of that round. And
all right.
Conlon was in trouble.
You've got to keep it nice and tight now. You've got to have to keep it all the time. Get your own jab on and bring it up the middle yourself. Now let's start finishing in the left, dude. Let's clear your head first. Everything behind the jab. Don't get too close. Little half a step back, up the middle left hook. You just shook him with your own shot then. So you're going to have to be careful, he's going to come out blasting now. Now's your chance, you've got to start using all your experience and keep it nice and tight, OK? Everything behind the shot.
That's an understatement. He will certainly go looking for him after that. Oh, legs did a funny little dance.
He was hurt, he don't want to be able to do Conor's credit. He did well to survive, you know. Seconds. Kept moving his head. Recovered well, but tried to fight back as well, but... Granados just rushing his work a little bit there, but he hurt him with that right hand, and that's a dangerous sign for Conlon now.
Three rounds to one now. Barry has got the Mexican, Junior Granados, ahead against Jamie Conlon from Belfast. Conlon needs to regroup to show real fighting instinct to survive in those closing stages of the fourth. To find a good counterpunch to Conlon in the very closing seconds of that round.
He was boxing quite well up until that point, but it was such a good arm, good shot. Good response here from Conlon, man.
Needs a good round. Needs to get some respect back.
But he was having a good round, wasn't he? That's the problem. But this guy, obviously, you you can't switch off. I think you've got to put him on.
Lovely right hand again.
You've got to put him in retreat.
Absolute key stage of the fight, you sense this one. Conlon needs surely to win this round, and he needs to continue what he's done so effectively in the first minute and a quarter or so far. And this is good from Conlon.
You've got to make space for that right hand. You've got to throw a jab to the head, jab to the chest, and then the right hand over the top there, Jamie Conlon.
Good shot. Beautiful shot. Well timed.
A little bit off balance there as well, Grandma Ross.
Hand over the top from Granados, that's the danger punch again, and he didn't miss by a lot. Concentration.
But as Danny Vaughan said, you've got to keep that left hand, you've got to come straight back to the chin every time. Can't leave it dangling low. Granados slides in the distance for a shorter fella, he slides in the distance really well.
Well, Granados is looking for that big shot, and he's maybe guilty of looking for it a bit too much because his work rate has noticeably dropped here. That's maybe a tribute to the good boxing skills of Conlon.
Yeah, I think it's a bit of all. I think he thinks he's looking to time that big right hand, but also Conlon came out quite positive, more positive than you'd expect. I think we just got hurt.
Good body shot and good footwork as he stepped away as he landed it. Again for the Irishman.
Up to this point, it's been a really good round for Conlon. First round by far.
Key points in the fight. If that's the case, then Conlon is passing the test, but it was about now when Granados landed the huge punch in the last round. Concentration still etched across those almost Hispanic features of Jamie Conlon. And this has been a very good round indeed, and he's taken this fifth by a distance.
Do you know what? He showed a lot of good character there to come back after being hurt. Boxed really, really well. Very composed.
Good fast hands. Punishing him when he missed. Look at that beautiful accuracy and speed.
And he needs to make more room for that right hand more often, and it is that jab to the head, jab to the midriff, and then right hand over the top.
I want you to build on that behind the jab. Listen to me. Now look for the shots around the side. Jab, stab the body, right hand. Try one up the middle. But look, you can't afford to drop them like that right hand. Let's then keep back to your chin all the time, eh? So let's build on that. That was a good round. How are you feeling?
Yeah.
You've settled down now, haven't you?
Yeah.
Yeah, so you know this kid, you know, he's quite sharp. So don't give him fuck up. Everything behind the jab. Jab, round the sides, up the middle. But tight, and then you see him bring that left hook into it, yeah? Just give yourself that little bit of room all the time.
Lots of problems. Has he begun to find the answer? Danny Vaughan thinks so. At halfway, we've got Granados on Barry's card, leading by 3-2. That was a really good round for Conlon.
Needs to maintain
that momentum.
Do you know what? If he goes on to win this fight, he ticked a couple of boxes there, coming back, surviving a round being hurt, and then coming back and dominating the next round.
Well, we said, did we not? Oh, good shot! Slip, though, not giving us a knockdown, and around the back of the head as well. Kind of hooked him down, hooked him in the sense of pulling rather than the sense of a righting.
You've seen those given before, though, John.
We're talking, we, about the need to find a plan B. It was just a case of settling down and getting into a stride, Conlon, but he appears to have done just that.
Well, sometimes when you come into a fight, expect, even though you train hard for a fight, and you're always respectful of your opponent, when you're expected to win, mentally you can't always get the right mind frame for it. So now he knows he's in a fight.
Maybe, he certainly does.
Yeah, really does.
Smash to the head at the end of the closing stage of the fourth round was as big a reminder as a fighter could possibly get without actually being decked. Good jab from Granados.
And to be honest, he could have even won that round, but he was dominating most of it before the big right hand.
Is trying to raise his work rate, trying to walk his man down, get into range.
But the work rate has dropped. He's still coming forward, Granados, but the punch output has really dropped. And I think that might be to do with along with Conlon.
I think it's mindful of the right hand. One thing about Conlon saying, yeah, in a corner saying, watch for the right hand, keep the jab, keep the glove drawn back and keep it tight in. But Granados as well has been hit by some really stinging right hands.
Is that right hand again from Granados?
Close around this one.
Long. Those straight punches are working excellent for him. Don't give this fella anything, don't give him anything at all.
Both of them landed quality right hands there. Granados was just looking to Mickey Van for a little bit of aid, wasn't he, when he thought the one had gone around the back of his torso. Sometimes when that happens, indicative that a fighter is starting to feel it a little bit. Conlon finishing strongly.
Yeah, another good round I felt for Conlon. Again, Granados constantly coming forward, a lot of threatening, but the punch output has dropped dramatically.
Okay, I want to see you back him up a little bit now, yeah? You're looking stronger than him now, you've settled down. The things are coming into play now. Okay. Listen to me. I want to start double jab right hand. Double jab right hand, two threes, right hand left two. Back on the jab again. Be careful though, you've got to keep that left hand tucked. But look for it now, one, two, left, two to the body every now and then as well. Okay? How are you feeling?
Good.
You feel all right now? You're settled down now, yeah? Let's touch on that right here on the right side here. Jimmy, just look that side, isn't it? Okay, the jab's winning the fight for you, yeah? You've just got to keep up on that jab, but I want you a little bit more weight out of you now. Okay?
Yeah?
Feeling all right, yes?
Yeah.
Okay.
We've got the fight level now.
Double jab, 50-year-old the centre.
Push him a little bit. Round seven.
But that fifth round, what a big round that was as we move into the seventh now. That was the key moment in the fight, and that showed real experience, guts, and no small amount of class from Jamie Conlon as he maybe reversed what was starting to look like a tide flowing against him.
It's that, yeah, it looks so far, as long as he keeps his concentration, Jamie Conlon, now he's starting to get a little bit of rhythm, good rhythm in his work. Just needs to keep that concentration, you can't get this guy any openings as we've seen. But Granados' work rate has dropped dramatically, and I just think maybe he is a victim of a guy who's maybe more overconfident with his power.
Well, he knows now, or rather his corner should know, that he now is at the point where he needs a big round. A fascinating contest.
Yes, and I've got it level, but I think that's the hope, that's the best that Granados can hope. If anything, he could be done with a lot too long by now. Good right hand.
There's more of an urgency about his work now.
I think.
That's a right hand again from Granados. That's a dangerous punch.
Conlon got to change that direction. He's always moving to the left. Just got to mix it up a little bit. Change direction every now and again.
Mexican corner getting pretty animated. They think their man's still very much in here with a shout. And he's having a much better round so far.
I think Conor's got to stand his ground a little bit. You know, I think he's the one who's got to move. He's the one who's got to do more than moving back. But he's giving away too much space. He's giving away too much of the ring.
And all of a sudden, the jabber is being out-jabbed by the smaller man. Oh, good shot, body shot, right hand. Well, that has really taken the wind out of Jamie Conlon. Is he going to get up? I'm not sure he can. The crowd imploring him to get to his feet. Well, he gets up just.
Got to keep those elbows light and tight now, nice and tight.
Now Granados looks to take him out, looking for more big body shots. He's going to go again, I think. Mickey Van's poised, he's looking. There's still more than 30 seconds of this round as a hailstorm, firestorm of punches comes raining in. And Conlon is not firing back. Mickey Van is giving him every opportunity, but he's taking an absolute shellacking in there. Huge attack this from Granados. but he will not get Conlon out of there. Conlon fighting only on instinct as one lands while he was on the ground. But is this all over? Have his world title aspirations dissolved here? Can he get to his feet this time? Yes, he can, he says. And he gets up at nine. His right eye is a mess, but somehow he gets up. But that is a huge, huge round for Junior Granados. A 10-7 round. And Conlon now, have his dreams gone west?
What a disaster. Is it just a case that he gave Granados too much space to work?
He was jabbed back. And this is how it happened. This is how it unfolded.
The whipping right hand, right across the body. You can't defend against them. They were horrible when you get caught with them. And to be fair to Conlon, he done well to get up from there. And this assault here, just before that, but he had him on the ropes for about 20, 30 seconds. If that was the other way around, the referee might have stepped in. We've got to be honest about that. The referee gave him every opportunity.
Okay. Yeah. He's going to pump. We've got to get them sides and hold them in. OK, let them go. OK, come on, let's see you show me some fucking ass. Come on, let's see what you're doing.
Massive problems now for Jamie Conlon. The crowd, I said they're a bit muted earlier on. Listen to this. It is an absolute bear pit in here. Great shot from Conlon. Opening punch of the round. He is now fighting for his ambition, for his dream. And he's come out firing. Two people now with this huge atmosphere urging Conlon on.
See, brilliant stuff here from Conlon. How brave is this?
Big body shot again from Granados. That was what started Conlon's disintegration in the last round, that slashing, whipping right hand into the body.
That's good, you got to push him back.
Terry Matthews in the corner there, bellowing his encouragement, and the rest of the team. Tom Stalker, I can see over there. The Macklin clan as well. Granados looking for that one big shot. Conlon has got to keep his work rate going. Protesting about use of the elbow there, Granados, as he was pushed back.
That's a few there from Granados, showing he got a lot of tricks in his arsenal.
The right eye of Conlon is a mess and is starting to close. Will it affect his vision? What a gutsy performance in the opening 2 minutes of this eighth round from Conlon. He's forcing Granados back.
But look how relaxed Granados looks, even though it's a great assault, great comeback from Conlon, and he's even winning this round. But look how relaxed Granados is, not worried about anything.
Down twice in that seventh round, Jamie Conlon, and still finding the guts, the resolve to deliver this. Now Granados is starting to measure him, starting to look maybe for a big telling attack in this last 30 seconds.
He's just trying to pressurise Conlon with the feet, make Conlon punch himself out. That's what he wants to do.
Good uppercut. A shot from Conlon.
You've got to push him back, Conlon. He's landing his shots, but Granados likes to walk forward. You've got to make him walk back, but he's not comfortable walking back.
Conlon has found extraordinary depths of desire and a fitness in this round, because he's won this round for me. Even though he's having to dig so very deep in the closing seconds, there's the bell to end the eighth, and what a response after a torrid seventh round. Remarkable.
That was just brilliant from Conlon. Again,
had
another bad round, came at a disastrous round, came back with a great display of courage, grit, determination.
Rolling all the time.
But I'm worried for Granados, look really comfortable there still, even under pressure.
All the time, yeah. That was a good round, you won that round, you've got to win these two rounds, yeah. Yeah, you listen to me, you've got to win them. Okay. can't give a fuck all, you've got to keep moving all the time. Behind the jab, roll, behind the jab, jab, jab the body, tight all the time, yeah? Okay? All right, you're feeling all right? Mm-hmm. Got it in you, yeah? Okay, you've got to roll them fucking, you've got to roll them chucking elbows in. Jab, look for it all the time. Finish with a left hook here and there. Keep that distance.
2 points, you've got to shoot it's called looks deficit on yeah. Barry's card. Two rounds remaining.
Seconds out, round nine.
Ninth round of what's turned out to be an absolute humdinger of a 10-rounder here. The crowd just responded fantastically to Conlon in that last round. Can he somehow maintain it, or is Granados now going to be able to move in and finish what he started in the seventh?
Pushing him back. Once he gives him a little bit of space to work, he can't stop him. Look what he did that last round there. Conlon went right at him with a powerful jab.
Conlon jumped, doubling up well with the jab there, but again, he's having to fight in reverse. Granados able to maybe make it his fight, walking Conlon down and looking for big body shots. Complaints again from Granados about Conlon's use of the elbow. Good right hand, that is.
Granados just shrugging it off, don't come back with his own right hand.
Oh, what a fight. If you've watched this at home, good decision.
What a smashing fight this really is.
Sort of fight which kind of reaffirms what attracts you to the sport in the first place. Astonishing display of bravery from Conlon to come back from where he was. Again, the use of the elbow from...
Be careful with that forearm, hasn't he?
Yep, and that time Mickey Van did speak to him. Shoulder going in this time as well from the Irishman. Not throwing too many punches now, but that's good.
They're giving him too much space.
Danny Vaughan and the other people in that corner bellowing to Conlon to use the jab. Jab, jab, put him back, get him into reverse gear.
He's boxing well though, Conlon.
There it is, doubling up. Beautiful.
Nothing troubling Granados though.
No, he's not moved him. And again, the use of the shoulder from Conlon, getting away with it. That's good from Conlon. Nice little sweet right hand. No huge power, but accuracy. Boxed beautifully in the latter stages of this round, Jamie Conlon.
He's shown some great resolve, hasn't he, to come back from some of the punches you've had to take. Brilliant work. Brilliant.
Oh, superb. Superb. That is a terrific round, and Jamie Conlon, what a performance he is producing here. He's clawed his way back, and he's won two rounds on the spin.
You know what, he didn't push him back like I wanted him to, okay, but he really dug deep there, the box on the move, excellently. But he got a hard round to start from, really hard round to come.
Seasoned faces shaking their head in disbelief of what's being shown here. Deliver on Barry's card. Look at that, lovely. There is 1 point in it to Granados, but a lot of those rounds which we gave to Granados were close. Good right hand from Conlon. Granados, I think, will probably think he's got to knock him out to win this on Irish soil. Conlon has been told in no uncertain terms, get out there and win this last round and win it big. If you've never been to this wonderfully atmospheric venue, do yourself a favour and try and get here and hope that it is a fight like this.
So great about this fight, you never expected this sort of fight. You really thought Conlon was going to be a bit of a test to dominate. He's absolutely fantastic.
He showed himself to be a rare fighting man, win or lose. The crowd, they believe they're watching a big Irish night, and he withstands another swinging, crunching right hand from Granados.
The right hand there from Conlon.
Into the closing seconds of what has been an extraordinary fight.
Good jab just then though here from Granados.
He's got to find one big punch though, Granados, you sense?
But you know, I think a really good round in the seventh has sort of harmed him in many ways, because he just looked for the big shot.
Boxed in the last two rounds, he's trying to keep the pressure on Granados, but he just can't find the punches. There's the big body shot. Conlon saw it coming and partially stifled the impact.
Boxing well on the move here so far, Conlon.
That's quality, real quality. Right hand spun his head around.
Didn't affect Granados though, didn't affect him at all.
He's got 30 seconds, the Mexican, to find the big shot. Partially blocked that swinging right hand. Conlon is just about spent, I think. Although we said that in the seventh, didn't we?
Oh, look at that. Beautiful.
Spent, not so.
He got no right throwing that sort of sharp punches. As tired as he is, cannot be quality work like that.
Well, the face of Jamie Conlon shows that he has had to go to war here. It has been a quite extraordinary performance coming back from that seventh round. One of the worst rounds a fighter could wish to have. He was on the cusp of being knocked out. Big finish from Granados, but he can't find the knockout punch. And what a fight that is. Those two lads will remember that forever. And look at the reaction of the crowd. They believe that Conlon has done enough. He's celebrating. The Mexican junior Granados also is celebrating and waving to the crowd. I tell you what, whatever the result, that was one hell of a fight.
It was absolutely phenomenal. It was just such a rare surprise, wasn't it? Just toe-to-toe action. Granados, we just didn't expect him to be as good as he was. And I didn't know that Conlon had that sort of resolve and grit and determination to come back. Absolutely brilliant.
Mickey Van was just leaning through the ropes when you were speaking there. Barry just having a word saying, what heart Jamie Conlon showed. Well, who's going to take it?
I got it level. I think Conlon won more rounds than Granados, to be honest. But Granados had two fantastic rounds. One of them was a 10-7, obviously.
He has dreams of a world title shot. This was for an intercontinental title shot. Some people say these belts don't matter. Tell it to these two lads.
It's not so much what you got, it's what you got to come.
What is it they said in Rocky? Not what you can give so much as what you can take. But Jamie Conlon took everything.
That body shot, that whipping right hand to the body in the seventh. How he got up from that was, he really had to ask a lot of questions of himself. And then the battering he took on the ropes as well there. You know, he really, really struggled to get up again.
To get up from that and produce what he gave in the last three rounds was mesmerising. Something that you'll never forget.
This is how gutsy Jamie Conlon is. His two worst rounds, the fourth and the seventh, were followed by his two best rounds in the fifth and the eighth. He really boxed well, but I got it level. Though, to be honest, I think Granados was a real fine tonight, real tough.
two British judges, one Spanish judge. How's it going to be? Long period in the corner. Everybody, I think, is just amazed at what Conlon showed here. And congratulations, beautiful to see as well, from the rival Mexican corner. Prior to the result being given, I think it's there now. I think Mark Burdis has got it, and we are ready to find out who has won this extraordinary fight. And referee Mickey Van congratulated both fighters. Mickey did a good job as well, letting the action flow. Not by any sense a niggly performance from him. A memorable fight. Who's won it? Let's find out.
Ladies and gentlemen, a round of applause for two warriors. Ladies and gentlemen, we go to the scorecard and we have a unanimous decision. Dave Parris, 96-92. Judge Martinez, 95-93. Judge DiGiovanni, 95-93. The winner, and now the WBO Intercontinental Super Flyweight Champion. In the blue corner.
He's got it. Jamie Conlon has got it.
Jamie Conlon.
The Irish celebrations tonight will be long and loud and deserved.
A round of applause.
A brilliant performance.
Julia Granados
gave it everything. He contributed to a quite wonderful fight. One of the very best I've seen for a long time. And Jamie Conlon tonight, well, what a performance. At times, it simply took your breath away.
Thank you, John. John Rawling and Barry Jones describing an absolutely enthralling fight. And the belts in the end go to Jamie Conlon, getting up after staring defeat in the face and getting a unanimous verdict against an outstanding Mexican who shook his head at the end and must have felt he'd done enough to get the decision here. Fought in a great spirit in front of a fantastic crowd at the National Stadium in Dublin, all on their feet at the end. The sort of sport that really makes us all fall in love with a game of boxing. A tremendous top-of-the-bill fight here. And well done to Jamie Conlon and all those people around him. But he will know he stared into the abyss tonight. He'd almost packed up this game once. And he was within seconds of defeat there. But he battled back to get the verdict. Great pictures. Great emotion as well. We'll hear from him in just a moment. But first of all, let's come to you, Arnie. Do you agree with that verdict? Do you think he won that fight?
I agree with it. Well, more than agree with it. I'm pleased, very pleased he won. He showed big grit and is a good fight down the line as well, in my mind.
I take it what you're saying. Steve, I'll say to you, I had it going the other way, I must admit.
Fair enough. I had it 95-93. I agree with two of the judges. But what I will say, he owes an in-debt to Mickey Van. He could have stopped that fight in the seventh round. If he had, no one in this arena could have or would have complained. But when he went down for that second time, when he banged that canvas with his right hand, as if to say, I will not be denied.
Yes.
If he had been stopped seconds earlier, no one would complain. But what a brave art Jamie Conlon was, and what about Grandos? What a visitor he was. It was absolutely fantastic. I'm trying to think of fights where I've seen some, and I've been covering boxing for 20-odd years, where I've seen someone, you know, come back from the brink. Certainly not in the last few years where someone's come in ringside to see someone come back from the brink. That was a stunning performance.
I'm not even going to go down the Paul Butler question here, but you will know, looking at him, there's no quit in this fellow at all.
No quit. You know what? He showed massive, massive art, and I'm proud of him because, you know, he was finished. About three times he was finished, and he grabbed himself off that canvas. Great he was.
And were you a little bit surprised that, being the naturally bigger man, he didn't enforce that physical superiority on the Mexican?
I don't understand why his corner didn't tell him to push him back from the start. Because James was so much bigger, so much stronger, and he let him get dictated.
It's going to be absolutely fascinating what Camp Conlon have to say about it there with Charlie.
Yeah, I'm just down here ringside. You can see there's so many fans around trying to talk to Jamie as well, but let's get in with him. Jamie, firstly, congratulations to you and your opponent for putting on such a wonderful fight and showing such heart, bravery and guts. From your perspective, did you think it was going to go your way, though?
Yeah, I believed when Danny told me at the end, I asked him how I felt. I had it by one or two rounds because it was boxing better and it was landing the cleaner punches at times, but he did land the bigger punches in some exchanges and I gave him ground, which I shouldn't have done, but that's just come with experience. And I thought it was a great fight. Start off, if it wasn't in that camp, I wouldn't have got through it. We had body shot and that round he put me down, and if it wasn't for S Crowd, not a chance. I would have stayed in that round. They got me through it.
And let's go to that round seven where you got knocked down twice. It could have been stopped. Obviously you were happy to carry on. What's your thoughts of that round?
Well, I knew I could see a ring coming. I was blocking most of him. He wasn't really landing clean when, after the shot. I said to Danny before we went in, my stomach doesn't feel right here. I think overread a wee bit in the day, and I felt like I was going to be sick when I went into the ring. So I was worried of the body shot, so it was always in the back of my mind. When he caught me the body shot, I knew where I was, and it was a great shot. But I just listened to the count and tried to hear Danny Vaughan's voice in the corner and just take my time and get my breath back. Once he got that round over, I knew it was over. I knew I had the fight because he gave everything and I had loads left.
Your heart was incredible. I mean, it was amazing to watch. But when you were on the canvas, you were right next to me the first time you got knocked out and you kicked your feet on the floor. How close were you to quitting?
Not close. Not close at all. Couldn't breathe in my nose. And I was trying to get my breath. And it just says, I don't want to say what I said in my head because I can't say it on TV, but it was a few curse words. And I just looked at him and says, ah!
Yeah, we can all use our imagination at home for that one. How surprised are you with him as an opponent? Did you expect that tonight? You expected it?
100 million%. Danny Vaughan told me about this guy. He watched him more than me. I don't watch more than a round or two. And he says he hits like a horse. He says he's small. And we didn't think we thought he was going to be smaller than that. He was bigger than Mama thought. When he hit me at the start, I didn't think, he doesn't hit hard. And then he hit me right hand and says, welcome to the game.
We can see how he hits like a horse by looking at you.
It's slow and thudding, but they were thudding in the back of the head in the air. But I knew where it was every time. When he hit me, I knew I had to get one back. It's only going to come with experience. This is a learning fight. Hopefully they're all not as tough as this, but if the fans like it, I like it.
You've mentioned Danny Vaughan quite a few times. Oh, he's just behind you. We'll talk to him in just a second. What has he done for you? Because that was your first fight under him.
He's a common influence on me. I've only known Danny about 7 or 8 months, but I feel like he's part of my family because he's so caring, so loving. He's did a lot for me over this 6, 7, 8 months of the training camp and being over with him in MGM. He's took me into his family, him and his wife Sandra. I can't thank them enough what they're doing for me. And I owe a lot to him in this fight, and I owe a lot to Sandra Vaughan. Get well soon, please.
Were you worried at all?
Was I worried at all? Yeah, you know, we just wanted him to stay behind the jab and box. We knew to kick a punch a little bit. We knew we were going to challenge for the world title. We can't get any knockovers anymore. We knew Junior was going to come to fight. We prepared. I mean, the camp we had, I mean, the body shot he got hit with, you know, he got up. He was fit enough to get up. He ground his teeth and got up and carried on. I had him 2 or 3 up going into the last round, but, you know, it was a really close fight. But, you know, he showed a lot of heart.
And you could hear all the fans screaming right behind me. How much do they mean to you?
I played Irish Rover as my walkout song as a tribute to Bernard Dunn because I used to watch him growing up in the stadium. And he was always hurt in his face and get the fans exciting face. I didn't think it was going to be as exciting as this, but it was a tribute to Bernard Dunn's days.
We were all rooting for you and all your fans. They were almost like your second boxer trying to box for you. Matthew, you've been a few tear-ups yourself as well.
Yeah, a real tough fight, but it'd be a great learning fight for him. We don't want him to have fights like that as someone that's, you know, you're managing and looking after, but, you know, he showed a lot of guts, a lot of character. He had to, you know, adjust, make adjustments, stand his ground, time, box at others, and it was a really, really good performance, especially considering he got dropped so bad with the body shots and he really sucked it up. But no, really pleased with him, great performance, and I think he'll go on and become a much better fighter from that fight. It was a great learning fight for him as well.
Jamie, you really showed what boxing was about. That must give you so much confidence now moving forward. We saw your interview at the start before you got in the ring, talks of Paul Butler. We've seen the words that you've exchanged, both of you, in the media. But now, That must give you so much confidence moving forward. What's next for you?
That's a brilliant learning thing. What's next for me? Danny Vaughan is going to scrutinise me bad. My dad back home is going to scrutinise me, because although it was a great fight and exciting for the fans, I made so many mistakes. I know I made the mistakes, and I got to come back and learn from them. Hopefully every fight's exciting, but a wee bit less exciting than that and more exciting in my favour.
Well, before I get pushed over by any more fans, because they're desperate to get to you, I'm going to let them come through and say congratulations and thank you again for putting on such an incredible performance. Thank you. Thanks, guys.